Hey everyone, this is Shaydo Gaming. I just want to give a brief explanation and a small tutorial on the OBS, Open Broadcaster Software, replay function. I actually went on a tutorial and kind of learned how to do it. I've just gotten around to doing it. And I'll post the link of the tutorial below so you can have a more detailed look on it. Now, you're going to need a couple of programs in order for this to work in a live stream setting. You're going to need Directory Monitor. You're going to need a video player of your choice, because this is how I'm going to be doing it. It's my own spin on the tutorial, and something that I would definitely want is more freedom in playing the replay, and what better way is a video player of your choice. I'm specifically using SM Player. You can use VLC, whatever you want, doesn't matter. And of course, Open Broadcaster Software. Now, all of those will be linked in the description below. Directory Monitor you can easily install, as well as OBS you can easily install and get those running. And let's get started. So we're going to go to the monitor here and we're going to show you what's going on. I already have SM Player up just for ease of use, and I already had Directory Monitor and OBS installed. Now we're going to go to the folders here, and wherever you installed OBS, depending on what you have, x86 or x64, I'm using the 32-bit version of OBS. You can use the 64-bit version. It doesn't matter. Both of them work. Now, you're going to go to OBS and make a folder called Replays. It's not in there before, so you have to make a new one. And you're going to want to make two folders, a buffer folder and a playback folder. Now, the buffer folder is going to hold all of the replays that you have made. If you haven't made any replays yet for OBS, you're going to want to make one now. Just make a regular recording folder and make sure you call it recording.mp4. So save it as an mp4 file, that'll be easier later. I already have one here. I also have a bunch of older replays, so you can check that later. It doesn't matter. Just make sure you have one in there at least. And you're going to want to go to the playback folder and make a batch file. Now, a batch file is very easy. If you can't see the file extensions like .bat and .mp4, just press the Alt key on this window here, go to Tools, Folder Options, View, and unclick this, Hide Extensions for Known File Types. Make sure that's unclicked and apply. Now once that's done, you're going to want to right click, make a new text document, and just call it update.bat for purposes in the video. I'm just going to call this one Replay because I don't want to remake another one. Now you want to change the file name or file extension of this file, so yes. And now you have a batch file, so that's nice. Now you're going to want to edit this batch file, right click edit, and you're going to want to copy this string of text. Now this will be also available on a paste bin on the link of the description, so you can check that out. So make sure you copy that and put that into the update .bat, update batch file. Now that's pretty much all you have to do on the folder side of things, so I'm just going to minimize that, and I'm actually going to be opening up the directory monitor. I already have one up and running right now, and I'm just gonna delete my previous entry so I can show you how to do this. Now you're gonna want to add. You can quick add by pressing this button here, and you're gonna want to go to the OBS directory of your choice, wherever you made the replay replay folder. Click replays, go to buffer and select this folder. So you want to select the buffer folder. Now you're gonna want to right click, edit, and then make sure all of these are the same as your settings, and then you're going to want to go to the execute tab. Now you're going to want to change the timeout to 5 seconds, the lowest amount that the program will give you. This is for a pop-up that'll happen later that I'll show you. Now you're going to want to go to the execute function on this program, and then go to your replays folder and go to playback and click the update.bat that you made. You're going to want to save. You're going to want to save that, and then that's pretty much it. You can close it. It'll be running in the background, and we'll see what it's going to be doing in OBS very shortly. Now we can actually finally get to Open Broadcaster Software and what we need to do to get that running. Now you're going to want to go to the Settings folder and go to Broadcast Settings, and you're going to want to make a replay function, a replay file already. I already have one set here, which is recording.mp4. And you're going to want to call it that, just for ease of use. Now, if you don't have a replay file, you can go to your hotkeys and make sure you have a save replay buffer key. It can be whatever one key you want. I'm using F12, it can be whatever you want. And you're going to want to make a replay. So all you have to do is go to this little arrow and press start replay buffer. If you don't have start replay buffer, it's already buffering. You can tell right here on the bottom that it's buffering because it'll say recording and buff. So all you have to do is press your save replay buffer key. And you'll notice a window popping up, and that's directory monitor doing its work. It's updating that batch file to make a lastrecording.mp4 shortcut that is saved in the playback folder. Now what happened here is that whenever OBS makes a new replay file in your buffer folder, it will update this lastrecording.mp4 shortcut to whatever was just saved. So you're going to basically have access, ease of access, to the latest replay that you have made in OBS, which is really useful because you can put this on SM Player and it's already ready to go. But if you happen to have made a new replay file, you don't have to constantly go to file, open, and pick a specific one. It'll always be lastrecording.mp4. So it's really cool. It's really simple and it's very easy to use. Now, how can we apply this to OBS? Now, with OBS, you can actually have a window function, window capture, and we're going to be actually capturing SM Player's window here, and I already have it set. You can actually go to Window Capture, and then add a window, and then go to SM Player, and then, you know, have it ready to go. If you can see here, all I did was just resize it correctly for the stream, and then put it behind the image overlay, which is pretty sweet. So we're going to be making a replay right now, and I can show you exactly what's going to be happening here. So we're going to have a main feed. I have Street Fighter 4 open up already, if you can hear in the background. So I'm just going to do a combo, and, you know, the commentators will be like, whoa, that was sick. So, you know, like, something might happen, right? So that just happened, and someone won the round, and you want to get a replay of it because it was really cool. So all you would have to do is press F12, and you notice something popped up. That's directory monitor doing its job. It'll close after a couple seconds. And then all you'd have to do is go to the replay folder, and ideally you'll see that sick combo. So it's pretty cool. Like, see, I can, and the cool thing about using a video player is I'm able to easily manipulate what's happening in this replay file. So like, I can go slow-mo, I can like unpause for like some cool stuff. And the commentators can be talking about this while dead air is happening. So if something's happening, like they're changing consoles, they couldn't find the player, player needs a controller, something happening, and they need something to talk about, they could talk about the replay. And you have it easily available for use for the commentators without really having to do anything, opening up new windows or anything like that. All you needed to do was prepare for it by using directory monitor, a video player, and a batch file or two. So it's really cool. It's really easy. The only problem here is you got to be more mindful of what's happening. You pretty much have to ingest the video or the live feed as you're streaming. So that's kind of hard when a match is getting really hype. If you yourself are getting hyped for a match, it's going to be kind of hard to figure out, hey, maybe I should replay this, or you might forget to press the key or something like that. So you got to be a bit more diligent and be more of a live streamer than a spectator watching the match. Other than that, it's really simple. It's easy to use. I mean, I could just tell someone, all you need to do for replays is press this button and then go to the replay folder or replay slide and then play it on the player. It's pretty simple. So it's overall a much easier system for a single live streamer to do, rather than having like multiple people ingest the video and then giving it to the streamer via cloud storage or whatever they've been using for like VGBC or Oxy or whatever other fighting game streams or whatever streams have been happening with instant replays. And this is all in OBS, which is pretty cool. Other than that, that's pretty much it. I think the only thing you have to really worry about is that since it's in OBS, whatever slides are going on here are going to be recorded in the replay, so you're not going to get a direct feed. So you got to be mindful of that. Other than that, it's pretty sweet. Very simple. It took me only a night to really figure it out, and so far I think this is what I'm going to be going with for tournaments. But if you like what you see, please follow me at twitch.tv/ShaydoGaming as well as youtube.com/ShaydoGaming. And that's pretty much it. I've explained what I'm going to be doing with it. Hopefully I'll be using it in more tournaments and events. Check out for events, we're going to be having a Smash Brothers tournament at Box Seats in the 31st of January, which is just the end of the month. And I believe SukiCon, an anime convention I'm going to be streaming and live or recording at, is going to be happening in February 7. So check those out. And if you like what you saw, thanks for watching. Appreciate it. And I hope I'll upload some more cool videos later. Thanks.